Hi there, I'm Agas, I'm from Kerala, Kannur, and I completed my plus two education at this year. So today I'm here to present it to you guys about how I cracked NID entrance. So first of all, I would like to start about my past. I mean, I started my drawing at the age of 5. From that day on, it always has been my goal to become an artist. I mean, for the first time being, I dreamed about being an artist. Then after that, I joined CC Lab. From there, I heard a lot of opportunities for an artist like NID, NIFT, Fine Arts. So when I heard about NID, it actually surprised me. I mean, I'm pretty amazed about NID. From that day on, it always has been my dream to achieve the NID. So the things that I do to get NID. So first of all, I would like to tell you guys about the steps. I mean, I would like to tell you guys about the step which connected to my work. So first thing you need to do is upgrade your drawing skills. I mean, you don't need to worry about your drawing skill. I mean, you don't need that such flashy, I mean, such a realistic, such a shading type drawing. All you need is a basic type drawing. I mean, a communicative drawing. All you need to do is, I mean, you need to, you will be able to represent your ideas in your paper. I mean, they just need to understand that. I mean, it's just a communication drawing, so don't worry about it. And the second thing is creativity. By saying creativity, I mean, first thing you need to do is actually think out of the box. I mean, by upgrading your creativity drawing skill, first thing you need to do is doodling. By doodling, you can able to make different shapes, and you can make it your own characters, make it your own work. I mean, for me, what I did was to watch anime. By watching animated series, it's actually has such a vast content of creativity. I mean, anime has no end. I mean, it's like an infinite resource pack. I mean, it has such content, like it helps you to create your content, and also helps you to draw comic strips. I mean, you'll be fine with watching anime. And the next thing is actually general knowledge. By saying general knowledge, you will be needed the general knowledge like current affairs, and also a little bit knowledge about the art and design. And the next and main and important thing is your language. By saying language, I would like to say that you'll be need both communicative English and literature English. What I did was I joined English class at CC Lab, and I started to read newspaper. By reading newspaper, you will be getting such a vast content of vocabulary and a high standard English. And also watching English sitcoms like Friends, Big Bang Theory, which helps you to improve your communicative English. And these are the things that you need to do to get an ID. And about my opinion about the written exams and the online direction, first I would like to tell you guys about the NID's exam system. There are actually three stages. First stage contains a written exam, which also known as the prelims. It has two parts, part A and part B. Part A contains objective type questions. You don't need to worry about it, just general knowledge and current affairs issues like that. And part B is a drawing type questions, and for me there were one composition and two posters and two comic strips. And the whole opinion about the exam was it's very good. I mean, we don't need to worry about it. It's actually a nice examination. And the second stage is actually the situation test, and the third stage is the interview. Due to the COVID pandemic, there were no second stages. I mean, they cancelled the second situation test, and there were only the written test and online interaction only. About the online interaction, you will be need to prepare a portfolio and a thematic representation. For me, there were theme poster, and the subject of the theme poster will be given to you at the end of the result. I mean, at the end of the prelims result. And about the portfolio, I mean, you can add anything. You can add any kind of work like photographies and paintings, animation, any types of work. I mean, you need to impress the interviewers. I mean, you need to impress that, and you will be gaining such a value to the interviewers. And the theme poster. About the theme poster, you don't need to overdo it. I mean, you don't want to make it an over abstract. All you need to do is actually making it understandable to the interviewers. And about the opinion about the online interaction. I mean, there is no need to worry about it, and you don't need to freak out about the online interaction. I mean, you will be thinking like it will be a job interview, like they will ask you such hard questions. Just don't need to worry about it. They'll just ask you some questions about yourself, about your background. I mean, all you need to do is actually reply it at the same time. I mean, don't take it too long. I mean, put your smart face on, like keep a smile on your face. I mean, if you smile at them, they will smile at you back. I mean, that will give you a possible vibe. And this is it. And this is actually the experience that I have experienced in the online interaction. And this is it. This is actually the things that you need to do to get an ID. I mean, as you can see, there is no shortcuts. I mean, there is no magic spell or any magic genie like that, cheat codes or any like that. It's just pure hard work. So I hope my presentation is helpful to you. So have a nice day. Thank you.